In the high-flying skies of jazz, some albums don't just cruise with the times. They soar ahead, leaving a trailblazing path. The year was 1959, a time when jazz took flight, launching a masterpiece that would trailblaze its way through the musical skies. Horace Silver's classic album, Blowin the Blues Away, was recorded at the legendary Van Gelder Studio in Englewood Cliffs, New Jersey. From its iconic tracks to the stellar lineup of musicians, this album became a shining light, illuminating the path for future jazz artists. And today, we're going to break this masterpiece down for you. So grab some tea, sit back, relax, and enjoy our video. But before you do this, please hit that like button, subscribe to our channel, and ring that notification bell to keep up to date with all our album insights. Thanks. Now fast forward to the present. I have a second pressing that's a 47 West 63rd NYC copy that's been in my collection like forever. I also have an Analog Productions copy that was released in 2010. And now I have a Blue Note Classic Vinyl Series reissue I received in the mail the other day. While all three versions have their merits, today our spotlight shines on my Classic Vinyl Series copy. I had a shootout between the two audiophile reissues and my Classic Vinyl Series with its punchier bass, shimmering cymbals, and detailed instrument separation, slightly edged out its counterpart. Now for the music. Sister Sadie stands as a testament to the transformative power of jazz. The track, with its pulsating rhythms and melodic highs, captures the listener's imagination from the very first note. Silver's masterful piano work weaves a rich mosaic of sound, while Mitchell's trumpet soars, adding layers of emotion and depth. Together, they craft a musical narrative that speaks to the soul. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Next up we have the Baghdad Blues, which is a musical journey painting vivid images of far-off places with every note. The track's rich melodies and rhythms conjure up visions of bustling bazaars and ancient landscapes. It's a testament to the power of music to bridge cultures, drawing listeners into a world both foreign and familiar, all while stirring deep emotions. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Last but not least, we have the title track Blowin' the Blues Away, which stands as the heart of the album, capturing its essence in every chord and beat. The track seamlessly fuses the raw emotion of the blues with the rhythmic intricacies of jazz. It's a musical journey that takes listeners through highs and lows, reflecting the passion and craftsmanship of the artists behind it. Please listen closely and tell me what you think in the comment section below. Now for the musicians on this classic. Horace Silver, a pioneering figure in the hard bop jazz movement, brought his distinctive compositional and pianistic flair to Blowin the Blues Away. His gospel and blues-rooted style laid the foundation for the album's iconic sound. From his early days in Norwalk, Connecticut, to his rise as a leading jazz artist, Silver's legacy is marked by innovation, soul, and an enduring influence on the genre. Junior Cook, with his tenor sax, added a robust and melodic dimension to the album, complementing Silver's piano intricacies. Having played alongside jazz greats like Art Farmer and Freddie Hubbard, Cook's rich history in the jazz scene shines through in his expressive solos and harmonious interplay on the album. Blue Mitchell's trumpet work on Blowin' the Blues Away is both warm and invigorating, adding a layer of melodic brilliance to the band. Renowned for leading his own sessions and collaborating with jazz luminaries like John Coltrane and Cannonball Adderley, Mitchell's storied career is evident in the depth and emotion he brings to each track on the album. Eugene Taylor's bass lines on the album provide a rhythmic foundation, grounding the album's dynamic tracks with depth and resonance. Throughout his career, Taylor collaborated with various jazz icons, and his seasoned experience is profound in the way his bass seamlessly weaves into the structure of the album's sound. Louis Hayes, with his propelling and elaborate drumming, added a rhythmic heartbeat to the album, driving the band's energy forward. From his early collaborations with jazz legends like Horace Silver and Cannonball Adderley to leading his own groups, Hayes' dynamic style and vast experience have solidified his place as one of the premier drummers in jazz history. Today, Blowin' the Blues Away stands tall, a beacon for jazz enthusiasts, a testament to its enduring legacy. While my analog productions copy holds a special place, my heart leans towards my new classic vinyl series, a pressing that captures the soul of the original, but better. I want to thank you for joining us in this deep dive. But before you go, could you please smash that like button, subscribe to our channel, and ring that notification bell to stay current on more album insights in the future. Until next time, keep the jazz alive. Bye for now.